Marvin Clark will be making his third NCAA tournament appearance of his career, but his first with the St. John's Red Storm. We're joined by the senior forward now. Marvin, what piece of advice have you been giving your teammates about what it's like to play in March Madness?
Mainly just, you know, just living in the moment, you know, not making the moment too big, but really just living in the moment, making sure that, you know, no matter what, you gave everything you had, you know, you gave everything you had mentally and physically. You know, a lot of this tournament is about, you know, quick turnarounds, being able to watch film, learn new opponents as quickly as possible. And then when you step out on the floor, just, you know, doing everything to the full capacity that you're possible doing it to. Also, you know, just telling them it's win or go home, man. It's basketball, but at the same time, enjoy it. Like, enjoy the off-court aspects, enjoy everything about it. And at the same time, you know, it's a playing game. I've never been in this position before. But we're in it, but I just want to take the approach that we're not really in it yet. And I think that's, you know, that's the big message that I'm trying to relay to the team, is just to be hungry. And, you know, right now, even though we're playing a playing game, we still have a chance to make it as far as anybody, you know. So that's really the message that I've been relaying.
Why does this team have the ability to make it as far as anybody?
I just, you know, think we have a versatile group. You know, we're lethal, man. When we're defending, rebounding, and getting out in transition, man, we're a scary team to play. And a lot of teams across the country have expressed that to us. And I think, you know, we just got to fall back on that and really, you know, make that who we are and really lock in on that. And if we do, I think, you know, we'll be on the better side of the end of the game.
Who are those teams that have expressed that to you? Bring that up.
A lot of teams, you know, in the Big East. You know, some teams that beat us, like Providence. You know, Coach Cooley, you know, he said, you know, stop them from getting dunks and you know, flashy plays, and you have a chance to beat them. And you know, teams like that. You know, we really struggled against this year. Big teams like that really junked the game up, slowed it down for us. And but with that being said, we've learned a lot through those games and figured out how to win one of those games in the Big East tournament against DePaul. So. You know, we just got to play our game, man, and just have fun and just relish in the moment.
What stands out about Arizona State?
You know, they're identical to us, very identical. A team that likes to get into you, get out and go. A team that gets it up. And Bobby Hurley lets those guys go. And, you know, I give, you know, all the credit to them. You know, they're a great team. But we're very familiar with them. You know, we played them last year, so it's kind of crazy how things work out, how it's really kind of a revenge game. We played them in L.A. last year, lost to them late. But it's really a revenge game, and we're really looking forward to it.
When you're identical stylistically, what can you do to find separation?
Well, you know, they're like us, you know. Like I said, very quick, very athletic, but a very emotional team as well, just as we are a very emotional team. But if we, you know, we have the experience. We have, you know, me being a fifth-year senior, Justin Simon, you know, who's played in this tournament, Mustafa Heron, who's played in this tournament. So, you know, just having that experience and you know, having that many players being able to play in this event, I think, you know, that gives us the upper hand.
Finally, how cool is it to be on the first team in the Chris Mullin era to be dancing?
It's dope, man. It's unbelievable. You know, coming here, you know, this is something that, you know, was a challenge, and was a challenge that was given to me, laid out in front of me, and I accepted it. And, you know, to all those kids out there, you know, that wanna, you know, make something happen, make something special, you know, I say go for it, man. You don't have to necessarily go to a blue blood to make things happen. So, you know, if you're one of those kids that want to work hard and, you know, play for a coach that's new, that's learning as you're learning, I say, you know, shoot for it, shoot for the stars.
Thanks so much.
Appreciate you.